Hi, I'm Christal. I'm a drum teacher from Singapore, and the most frequent place you'll see me playing the drums is in my local church. If you play drums for your church, or you're thinking about playing drums for your church, or you're just interested in the perspective of this one Asian church drummer, then watch on, you might find this video interesting. Recently, I received a comment in Chinese on one of my community posts. Full disclaimer, I did study Chinese in school for 10 years, but nobody in my family speaks it and I'm pretty bad. But I will try to read this question for you. It says, 怎样去练习一场敬拜歌曲? 还有怎样能一下记住那么多的歌曲? 而且每周都在换不同的音乐? 怎样去安排练习时间? That was so awkward. What that means basically is, how do you practice or learn a praise song? How are you able to remember so many songs, and every week you're changing different songs, you're changing your set list? How do you organize your practice time? And I think that is such a fantastic question. It's not easy to answer, but it's something that probably a lot of newer church drummers who are starting out might be wondering. So let's just look at this one part at a time. The first part of the question is about, how do you practice a praise song or a worship song, any song for church? I'm gonna guess that you would need to learn the song first. This person kind of asked about practicing, but you would need to learn the song before you can even practice it. And how you learn a song really depends on your current level of drumming competencies and whether or not that song falls within them. So what do I mean by drumming competencies? If we were to really simplify this, I would say the first main point to look at is your drum vocabulary. Do you actually have the vocab needed to play this song? And the second part would be, do you have the speed needed to play this song? So when I talk about vocabulary, I'm referring to the groove environment of the whole song, which is that particular feel and the type of coordination the song is written in. So for example, if there was a song that was written in a shuffle beat, that's a triplet-based groove, but you've never played a shuffle in your life, you're not going to be able to learn that song really quickly until you work on your shuffle coordination and you practice playing grooves that are based in that feel and that subdivision, and then it'll be a lot easier to learn the song. The second element, of course, is speed. So based on our hypothetical shuffle song, if you could play a shuffle, but your maximum speed is 80 beats per minute, and that song was at 120 beats per minute, again, it's going to be really hard to play that song off the bat. So when we talk about competencies, I would first think, can I actually physically play this song? Do I have the coordination necessary, and do I have the speed necessary to play it? So back to our original point about how we learn a song. If it doesn't fall within your drumming competencies, then you need to work on those things first before you even start playing the song. If I had to learn a song that was way too difficult for me in the sense that it used some coordination I didn't have, or it was too fast for me, I'm not even going to touch this song yet. I'm probably going to grab a couple bars or a couple examples of whatever it is that I can't do, isolate that idea and work on it outside of the context of the song first until I was comfortable enough with that concept to apply it to the song. The difficulty in trying to do this happens when you really, really need to play a particular song for your worship set that's happening in 2 or 3 days' time, and you don't have a lot of time to practice. Then what do? I would say just simplify it and use the vocabulary that you already have. Figure out a beat that works to support the song, even if it's not exactly what the original drummer played. Let's be honest, it probably doesn't improve our skills a lot as drummers because we're not actually actively expanding our vocabulary, but you are still improving in your musicality and your musicianship because you're still playing and delivering a song. On the other hand, if you do have the necessary vocabulary to play that song, then that's great. You can actually learn and execute the song pretty much how it was intended to be played. So there are two ways to go about this. One is just figuring out all the parts or getting your hands on the notation, if you can do that, and just learning it start to finish. And that's great. You really learn the exact parts for that song. Let's say you drill them bar by bar until you can play everything. But I would say that this is a rather limited way of learning a song because you are just learning a song rather than the different components that make up the song. So personally, how I prefer to learn a piece of music is to break it down in terms of the overall structure first. The first thing I do when I get a piece of music is to write down the sections. How many bars are there in the intro, the verse, the chorus? What is the overall flow of that piece of music? And then I'll try and identify the feel or describe the beat in each of those sections. For example, maybe the verse is using a rim knock groove on a closed hi-hat. The chorus is using a floor tom based groove with a backbeat on four. Something like that, just breaking it down into shorter ideas that you can actually understand versus just a stream of notes. And that would be kind of my big picture sketch of the whole song, which I'll then go back in and fill in details as I learn the piece of music. This is exactly why I do worship drumming tutorials the way I do. I don't want to be playing too much or too little, so I try and just play what the original parts were. I give you the notation so that hopefully you'll be able to hear what the actual parts are on a music track, but I'm also trying to give you the section titles and a little bit of description of what you should really be listening to in each section, because to me that is more important to understand than the actual details of the notes. Those are great to have, but they are still secondary to the overall structure of the song. When you have this in mind, that I'm just breaking the song down into its overall structure and remembering concepts for each section, then that kind of answers point 2 and 3 of the original question, which is, how can you remember so many songs and, you know, you're having different songs every week? The answer is, I'm not remembering all those songs. I'm just remembering the structure of them. Personally, my main tip would be to pay attention to the melody when you're learning a song, which sounds a bit ironic because as drummers, the first thing you want to hear is the drum parts, right? But you are going to be controlling the drum parts. Somebody else will be singing the song, unless you happen to be worship leading on the drums, in which case, more power to you. I think that's amazing. But most of the time, we are supporting a vocalist who is going to be giving the overall direction. And if you can create drum parts that support the melody of the song, it will help you to understand the structure of the song so much better, and you'll be able to play in a more musical way. So that's probably my biggest tip for this video. It's just pay attention to the melody, support the melody through your drumming. That is, to me, the most important thing, especially in church worship drumming. Different churches will have their own different favorite song lists and go-to songs, but usually a church is not going to span 20 different genres of music. Most churches are fairly limited to a handful of genres, and once you get very familiar with the common structure of songs in that particular genre or those few genres, you'll start to see some common trends in the structure of songs. Once you've learned enough songs within those few genres, you will start to realize that songs within the same genre often contain similar structural elements, and over time it becomes even easier to remember a song because you don't even have to remember the structure anymore, because the structure is so similar across different songs, there's kind of a default structure. All you need to remember is actually the parts that are different. For example, a typical phrase is usually 8 bars long in most rock and pop type music, and the only thing you would need to remember is if your phrase was longer or shorter than 8 bars. That would be your main thing to remember. Other than that, you don't even need to count the bars. You'll also start to hear commonalities in things like chord cycles and how those relate to the drum parts. You'll be able to hear things like a resolving chord transition at the end of a phrase. Those are things that indicate that you're going to a new section of the song or that you need to play a drum fill. Like, all these things do get into your subconscious over time. That said, it is really difficult when you're first starting out to learn the whole set list and get used to the songs that your church plays, especially if you just joined the worship team, or even worse, you just joined the church and you're not familiar with the songs they play. Back when I first started, about 14 years ago, I remember being so lost because I had no idea what the right beats were to different songs. People would tell me a song title and I wouldn't know what song it was based on the title. I would do really silly things like start a slow song way too fast. Those were trying times, but it's all part of the learning experience. I think it happens to almost all of us. Let me give you guys one or two practical tips to get started if you are just starting to play in church or you are thinking about playing in church. One thing you can do is be very attentive to the actual song list when you attend service. Every week, make a note of the songs that are being played and then just choose one song to learn for that week. If you just learn one song off the set list every week, your song vocabulary is going to grow steadily over time and then you'll realize that pretty soon you'll be able to be familiar with the parts from most songs. Start with the general structure first, and then gradually fill in the little details as you learn each song. The second tip is more regarding your actual practice. For most of us, when we practice, we probably go on YouTube or Spotify and look up a copy of the song and then jam along to the track, which is great because it gives you context of what the music sounds like and you can pay attention to all the different parts that are going on in the song. But the downside of that is you limit yourself to the kind of feel you're playing, and you are also following the timing of that drummer who played on that record. So also try practicing on your own, just to a metronome, just play to a click. Make sure that you can keep time on your own, because in a band setting, you are the one dictating the pace for the band. As a drummer, you have to lead the band in your timekeeping. You can't afford to be following anybody. So that means you need to keep time and you also need to be aware of the structure because you are the one who needs to give the transitions for the rest of the band to flow from section to section. By just playing with the metronome, you're forcing yourself to be aware of every single part of the song and you're not relying on listening to the music to give you a cue to the next section. This means you need to be really familiar with the melody and the structure of the song. If you can, sing while you're playing. If you can't, just go through the song in your head, that's fine as well. Practicing to a click also means your playing is more exposed and you can really hear whether or not you are playing clean or you're playing sloppily, which sometimes can get hidden by the original track. I would also suggest practicing without the click, just on your own, to see if you can keep time. And make sure you don't speed up or slow down too much if you do have to play without a metronome. The final aspect of this question was about how I organize my practice time. And that is such a huge question. I think it'll take a whole other video, but I'll just give you a very general overview. So for me, there's three main elements. One is the very technical part where I'll work on things like rudiments, hand speed, all the pad work stuff. I would probably even include stuff like just basic hand and foot coordination drills on the kit in this category. It's all the things that aren't really very musical. Usually they're repetitive and you're just working on a particular pattern to increase the speed and it might not sound like anything, but they're all really necessary to be able to execute the actual music you want to play. The second category would have to do with your actual applicable drumming vocabulary. So think about things like groove environments, styles of music, fills that fit within that style, learning all those different aspects that make up a piece of music. So that would be section two of things to practice. And then the third one would be working on music and musicality, which would include things like learning songs or just being creative, jamming to tracks, as well as practice that you can do away from the kit. So I'm talking about just actively listening to music, identifying the structure of a song, trying to identify what the drummer is playing in each of those sections, and more importantly, why they're playing what they're playing. And this is the step that is the hardest to figure out, but usually the most rewarding if you can hear what in the music influenced that drummer to make certain musical decisions. That is really the thing that will help your own creative expression to improve. All of those three areas are important, but depending on what your priority is at the time, you might be focusing more on one or the other. When I was just starting out drumming for the first couple of years, I definitely put a lot of emphasis on the technical side because I literally just was not fast enough to play a lot of the things I wanted to play. So that took up a huge amount of my practice time. Back in the day, it would be like 3 to 5 hours just on the practice pad because my hands kind of sucked. And now, I kind of have that under maintenance mode most days. It's 10 to 15 minutes. And then I would spend more time on the other aspects, which would be building overall vocabulary and working on songs. If I have a show coming up, then it could be as much as 90% just working on songs because I need to prepare songs for that show. So it really depends on where you're at, but don't neglect any of those elements. That brings us to the end of this video. I hope it answered your question, even though I wasn't able to do so in Chinese, and I'm not going to embarrass myself by trying. So I hope that was useful to you. Send it to your church drummer friends if you think they'll find it helpful, or you can also check out the other drum tutorial videos on my channel, which I will link somewhere around the screen. And I will see you in the next one. Bye. Okay, what am I even going to title this?